Mr. Donn Davis, two events into the PFL schedule. I got to get your reaction so far, right? I mean, you had a year to plan for this. I mean, I know it wasn't the way you wanted to do things, but hey, at least it gave you some extra time to figure things out. What's the feel like two events into the year so far?
Fantastic. I don't think we disappointed MMA fans. We came out with a big-time fighter roster, major innovation, and most of all, every fight matters in the PFL. As you know, it's a regular season, playoff, championship format, just like the NBA or just like the NFL, where every fight matters. And I think for the first time, fans have said, wow, what it means to see every fight matters, and what does it mean to see a top-notch video production? The PFL showed up in 2021.
Yeah, I will say that's one thing about your concept that I really enjoy. The card ties together, right? I mean, you know, the first fight of the night, sometimes it may feel like on an island in another promotion, right? But in your organization, really, every fight kind of ties together. And I think that makes it intriguing. I kind of want to touch on that because I know you have a reputation of being a guy that likes to disrupt things. You know, you got like to change the status quo. Week number one, that felt like a disruptive event, right? You bring in a guy like Anthony Pettis, and it doesn't go his way. You know, you bring in a guy, you got a two-time champion in Lance Palmer, and it doesn't go his way. For you, what was that event like? Because it's like these are kind of some of your poster guys, your most marketable guys, and they fail. Sometimes I see the good in that, and sometimes I see the bad in that, right? So what was that like for you watching that happen?
Well, it's like any sport. Underdogs win, champions lose. This happens in the NBA. This happens in the NFL. So week one in the PFL, the fight card was the biggest fight card upset in MMA history. There's been bigger individual upsets, but not bigger card upsets. Pettis loses, Schulte loses, Palmer loses. Six world titles between the three. They were all minus 500 to win. They all go down. Now, if this was another promotion, you might not see those guys ever again. But week four in the PFL, they have their second regular season fight. They must knock out their opponent to earn enough points to get in the championship. A win is not enough. So what do you think you're going to see from Pettis, from Schulte, from Palmer in week four of the PFL? So if you're an MMA fan, that is the format. And that is March Madness meets MMA, where you've got three champions back up against the wall. Week four, must knock out to make playoffs. So to me, as a fan, that's what I want to see.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Like you said, it's not just win. They got to win in a certain way by a certain time. They got to get things done. We just never seen it before. I think it adds a little extra spice. I mean, you've got a great roster, but when you've got those kind of rule sets that they've got to work with, it makes it intriguing.
Look, in the PFL, championships are earned, not awarded. It's not about controversy outside the cage. It's not about social media followings. Best fighter wins. Win four times, become champion. Lose and go home. It's that simple. And the UFC is a fantastic product. It's just a different product. And if there is a McGregor-Mayweather, if there is a big Usman fight, if there is a John Jones fight, we all love that UFC product. But 95% of the UFC fights are not for a belt. They're not for the big names. And in the PFL, every single fight matters. That fighter doesn't win, see you next year. And we all love a game seven. We all love a game seven. And every fight is essentially a 10-minute game seven. And so if you haven't seen the PFL before, I encourage you to check it out.
Well, that's a great pitch. You nailed it right there. All right, talk about, statistics have always been a big part of the product, right? But you brought in this new thing, the fighter performance rating this year, which I find intriguing. I wonder how it would, kind of apply across the board at every organization. But talk about the development. I mean, what exactly is that? Because it is cool. I mean, I remember growing up and being a baseball fan and loving stats and all that kind of stuff. So it's kind of cool to see this because we've never had stats like this. But talk about this fighter performance rating. How did you come up with this, develop it? What kind of stock should we put into it as a number as it's being thrown out there?
Yeah, look, it's a great question. If you're a fan of baseball or football, you like statistics. In football, you have the QBR. It's an independent way to measure how that quarterback did in a game. We want to develop something similar in MMA. It's not just about number of punches, but the overall approach, the impact, whether it's a takedown, whether it's defense, whether it's a position. So we created a bunch of PhD guys. We ran 10,000 fight simulators, and we came up with a proprietary AI computer model, which scores the fight. It's one way of looking at it. One way of looking at it. And it says, if you knock somebody out, the performance rating is 100. So the maximum of the PFL fighter performance rating is 100. Everything less than that is obviously a not perfect round. And so far, through 20 fights this season, it's perfect. It's how the judges scored. It's how the fighting has turned out. It's one measure. And what's super interesting is if you're a newbie, we show it after every round. A lot of people turn into MMA and they go, who's winning this fight? Boy, I'd like some more context. I'd like another way of looking at it. So this is just not a technical measure. It allows you to get into MMA if it's new for you. And if you're more advanced, we give you more stats and more data to understand that fight. So the PFL FBR is displayed after every round who's winning and at the end of the fight. It's another way of seeing who won. Check it against the judges. Check it against your vote at home.
That's interesting. Stats have been, I feel like they're such a big part of your broadcast, more than really any other MMA product I've ever seen. So I guess, what was the genesis of that? I mean, why did you guys decide to invest so heavily in this? I mean, it's in the name of the cage, right? I mean, you guys are doing tech and more than I've ever seen. So why was that? Was it a passion of somebody, or you thought it was just something missing? How did that come about?
Yeah, look, John, great observation. It's true. We created the PFL Smart Cage, right? And so we do naming the cage exactly what we're all about, innovation. And to me, there's two things about it. If you're a fan, the more context you have, the better. You could ignore it or you could observe it. But the MMA fighter and the MMA fight is one of the greatest things you'll ever see. But a lot of people can't understand it. It's 10 minutes. It's six disciplines. It's very technical. So we're trying to give them other ways to appreciate it, point one. But point two, it all becomes real-time gambling prop bets. What's the hardest punch in this round? Will this Kayla fight end in under 1 minute? Will it be a takedown? We're introducing kick speed in week four as a prop bet. Never been done before. It's a series of motion cameras and chips. So everything is about understanding and appreciating or engagement in real-time prop bets. We'll be the first ever in combat sports to have real-time prop bets on a whole host of things, not just winning and losing, but speed, heart rate, early endings, and you'll see that with DraftKings starting in week four.
That's amazing. I could bet on a fighter's heart rate. Are you kidding me?
You're going to see it. We're actually going to call it the burn, and it's a combination of heart rate, intensity, distance traveled. So you're going to see from PFL lots of ways to engage, because remember, 50% of the fans in MMA are 18 to 35. We all love to engage in the sports that we're passionate about, and so gambling or betting with your friends in a pool is another way of engaging with this sport.
That's awesome. Well, as a Las Vegas resident, I'm certainly familiar with that, and it's growing across the nation, right? I mean, that's a big thing in sports across the board. So to get ahead of this, I think it's probably a really smart move.
Well, look, and the advantage PFL have is we're a fighter-first league. We work with the fighters and explain what is the product we're trying to put on for the fans. And we're trying to be the most innovative product, not just in MMA, but sports. And how do you give the fans more innovation, more engagement, more transparency, more access? And the fighters have worked with us to do that. So we can do things you cannot do in basketball, you cannot do in football, and you'll see them at PFL first.
Very exciting stuff. Well, we've had two great weeks so far. Week three is coming up this week, and a move over to ESPN, right? I mean, I don't know. Is that a big? I mean, it's interesting the way it's programming is delivered now, right? I mean, you've got, you know, ESPN Plus, ESPN 2, ESPN. I don't know. Is that still a big deal? Because it seems to me like, you know, proper ESPN is a big deal, but I don't know. Does that even matter anymore from a TV place? Or is this a big thing?
Look, we're honored. I think the product is so good that we're honored this week to be moving from ESPN 2 to ESPN main channel just because of the quality of the product. But fans find us on ESPN 2. It's very distributed. Fans find us on ESPN Plus. And also, look, we're in 160 countries with 30 different media partners. We're the first media property, not just in MMA, but in all of sports, that's been in 160 countries and has paid cash rights fees in 160 countries. In only its third year of operation. So I think it's about two things. One, MMA is in high demand, And other than UFC, PFL is the number two MMA company worldwide. And number two, it's a good product. It's an exciting product. It's a differentiated product. So yes, we're delighted to be on ESPN this Thursday, 7 to 11 p.m. So you'll see 4 hours on ESPN. But ESPN2 is great. All of our media partners, all 30 of them around the world in 160 countries, you can find PFL everywhere.
That's awesome. And I guess in looking at this week's card, I mean, I know every fight matters, but Fabricio Werdum, Kayla Harrison, I mean, those are two pretty exciting names. For you, is that what this week is about? Or are there maybe some hidden gems or other things that we need to know about that people should be looking forward to this week?
Well, look, yeah, I would make three quick comments. One, as you say, look, there's 10 fights this week. And we've had, in every championship, three favorites win, three underdogs win. You will be surprised each and every week and each and every playoff. So there is no undercard in the PFL, right? So point one is, every fight does matter. Find your favorite. Ray Cooper III was an undiscovered nobody 2 years ago, and now he's a fan favorite champion. So find your champion in the PFL is point one. Point two is, other than Amanda Nunes, Kayla Harrison is it in the women's world. Now, ESPN still doesn't give her props yet. You see the pound for pound rankings, they're missing out because they are still very UFC centric. But even Dana White says the only fight left for Amanda Nunes is Kayla Harrison. She is it in the women's world. And if you haven't seen her, see her. And the last is Werdum. He is the Tom Brady of MMA. This guy's 42 years old and still beating up on people 30 and 28 and 26 years old. He is operating at the highest level. He has four belts from four organizations, and he's going for his fifth belt with PFL. This guy is not only a class act like Tom Brady, but is operating with his mind and his body at the highest level. And you should check him out with his last two-year contract to ever fight. Those are the three storylines I would tune in this Thursday to see.
I dig it, man. Well said. Yeah, who came up with the Tom Brady of MMA? Did you come up with that? It's pretty good. I mean, Verdum's up there, and he's been around for a long time. Did you come up with that one?
I can't take credit for this. This is a team effort.
I like that. I saw it in the press release. It made me laugh. I like that one a lot.
Yeah, but I would say, literally, and above all else, to me, I love the TV product. For people who do not know, PFL is a made-for-TV product. We're focused on the 10 million people watching, not the people attending. Therefore, everything about our show is optimized for TV. And I know, John, you've seen it. Many people do see it. But if you haven't seen it, the innovations that we've released even this year have wowed people. We've even done something called the ghost cam, which makes the cage disappear. So when people are fighting next to the cage, you just see the fighters, not the cage. We've introduced, as you've seen, fan social voting. You see after each round how global social media is voting the winner of this round. So if you haven't seen this TV product, got to check it out. You haven't seen anything like it in MMA or combat sports. That would be my encouragement for week three. Even more exciting than these fights is, wow, check out this video product.
Yeah, you nailed it. That's the pitch. Look at you. You're a professional. It's like you've done this before. That's spot on, though.
Yeah, but your show. Right? I'll come on every week on your show.
I appreciate it, man. Last thing I want to ask you, what can you tell us about the rest of this year, right? We're wrapping up kind of phase one, I guess you would consider it right now, this first three-week stretch. We know we're coming back in June. Do we have playoff dates and locations yet? I mean, that's what it all boils down to, right? We get past the regular season, then we move to the championship round. So do we have that all set in stone? I mean, I know it's tough, COVID times, right? You got to be flexible.
And I'll brief the fans now on what we could tell them. So for those who don't know, the regular season is 6 weeks. So it breaks down 3 weeks in a row. And we're entering this Thursday as our third week. Each fighter has two fights in the regular season. They fight once in the first 3 weeks. Then there's a three-week break. The second part of the regular season is also 3 weeks. Each fighter fights again. So each fighter has two fights in the regular season. And the most points from those two fights, the top four fighters in each weight class advance to the playoffs. Those playoff dates are in August, and those have been set. So it's August 10th, August 17th, August 24th. So it's 3 weeks in August, all Friday nights, all ESPN, 9 p.m. primetime. We're going to announce the location later this week, John. But it's three prime times, 3 weeks in a row, all in August is the playoffs. And it's single elimination, four fighters, four against one, two against three, and they all advance to the championship. And that will be in August this year, which is fantastic. There's nothing else to do in August. Friday night, 9 p.m., ESPN primetime.
Yeah, that's perfect. August is always kind of that slow time with sports, right? You guys nailed it right there. I like that. That's exciting.
Yes, and as we said, it'll be six weight classes, the top four in each weight class, single elimination. So this will be the best back-to-back-to-back 3 weeks, probably in MMA, that we'll see this year. Be super exciting.
Exciting. Well, listen, Donn, I always appreciate your time, man. It's very cool to catch up with you. And I know it's probably was a tough year away, but you guys are doing big things. I guess, do you want to make one last pitch? If there's anybody that's not sure if they're on the edge, you know, I don't know. I'm already watching UFC. I got a little Bellator in my life. I don't know if I got time for this PFL thing. What would you say? Hey, you know, why that MMA fan needs to watch PFL as well?
Well, here's what I would tell you. There's 550 of you. There's 550 million MMA fans around the world. There's only 35 UFC events. There's 6,000 basketball games. We're all inundated with sports. Check out the PFL. There will be a new fan made every single moment. You will not leave it. UFC, great product. PFL, a differentiated, great product. We will make you a new fan. You will not leave.
My man, that is perfect. Well, I appreciate it. 2021 PFL 3 this Thursday night. Big ESPN, ESPN Plus. Donn Davis, thanks for the time. We'll have to do this again. This was fun.
Anyway, John, thanks. And you have to come to week four. Week four, Clarissa Shields makes her MMA debut. The number one pound-for-pound boxer ever in women makes her MMA debut in week four of the PFL. So I will be back. You will be there. And we'll talk Clarissa becoming the Bo Jackson of MMA, and we will talk about that then, all right?
You got all the taglines. All right, we'll talk about it. We'll talk soon. Hopefully you can make it. Best of luck.
Thank you. Take care.